In this video, we will see how to manually clean a print head of an Epson EcoTank printer. This type of cleaning is only recommended when automatic nozzle cleaning does not resolve inkjet problems due to nozzle clogging by dried ink. Manual cleaning consists of injecting a cleaning liquid into the head nozzles to dilute the dried ink and eliminate its clogging. It can be injected directly onto the head, removing only the ink tanks, or as in this video, with the head removed. In this way, we avoid dirtying the printer, and we can also see if the nozzles are unclogged or not. We start by turning on the printer, and we disconnect it from the electrical network when the head reaches the end of its travel. In this way, we can place the head in its disassembly position. We remove the ink tank cover. We remove the pipes from the guide rail. With a lever, we press each tank from behind so that it comes out of its housing. Now we can extract them and move it aside. We extract the ink tank support by pressing its lateral tab on each side. We remove the side cover of the flex cable, pressing its lower part and pulling up. We remove the three screws from the injector head. Now we can remove the head from its housing. We disconnect the flex cable from the injector head. We must remember that the connection makes assembly sense. We will inject the cleaning liquid into each inlet duct of the injector head, and we will pour it into a container. We inject the liquid into each of the inputs to the injector. We inject little by little, with enough pressure for the liquid to come out. We must be careful that liquid does not enter the electronics of the injector head. It would cause damage to the head or printer due to electrical short circuit. So we must avoid getting it wet or submerging the injector head in the liquid. At first, it will come out mixed with the remaining ink from the head. The liquid should come out in a continuous stream. Here we can see it better. The liquid must come out of all the injection nozzles, continuously and without drips. In the event that the liquid does not come out because it is very clogged by the dried ink, we can try leaving the liquid injected into the head for a few minutes, so that the ink softens and can dissolve. Once we see that it is now unclogged, we dry it a little, and reassemble the head on the printer. We connect the head flex cable in its correct position and orientation. We place the injector head in its support and screw it on. We place the support for the ink tanks. We assemble the ink tanks in their correct order. We place the pipes in the guide rail. We mount the side cover that holds the flex cable. We orient the lid and press down. We finish by placing the protective cover on the ink tanks. Now we must get the ink to the injector head. We will do it by performing an automatic cleaning with the Epson software. Several cleanings may be necessary for the ink to reach the tanks and print correctly. Once the automatic cleaning is finished, we can perform an injector test to see the results. If in the test the printing result is not correct, we can perform another automatic cleaning. Epson recommends that after several automatic cleanings, the printer rests for 12 hours, so that the printing is correct.